office collaboration really started day one when I arrived at Saul Ewing. At my prior firm, the experience was more pushing work out to the four corners of the firm with very little reciprocated. What I found is a totally different experience at Saul Ewing. From my first day at the firm, I was getting contacted by partners in other offices who had client relationships that they were eager to have me participate and at some times lead. That was a truly refreshing and rewarding experience that has continued to this day.
One of the reasons that I wanted to make a move is I came from a very large firm that had a number of offices, almost 50 offices across the world. But one of the things that I felt that I didn't know really well were my colleagues in a lot of other offices. I was in one of the largest offices here in Pittsburgh. And I wanted to have the opportunity with whatever firm I looked at to have cross-office collaboration. And I've definitely had that here at Saul Ewing. But I would say that probably about 75% of the matters that I've worked on since coming to Saul Ewing have been cross-office and cross-practice group matters. And that's been great. That's exactly what I was looking for. And it has definitely borne itself out since I've been here.
Collaboration in this firm is something that we really pride ourselves on. The firm is not siloed in any way. And when I have a client issue that I cannot handle, I feel like I can pick up the phone and call any other office or any other individual in the firm, whether it's inside my group, inside my department, or outside of the department. So whoever I call either is there or will call me back. And whether it's billable or non-billable, or I'm just picking somebody's brain, they seem to answer my question, stay on the phone with me, and really make sure that the client gets the answer that they need. There's no sense of, you know, it's my client or their client. It's our client. It's a firm client. So it's been a great success, something I haven't really seen at the other firms I've been at. And it's been very helpful for all the clients of the firm.
When I met with attorneys at Saul Ewing, from the managing partner of the law firm all the way down to junior associates, I heard two things, and two things that really helped me ultimately make my decision to join Saul Ewing. And those two things are culture of collaboration and how the firm supports entrepreneurial attorneys. With regard to culture of collaboration, candidly, I'm sure we've all heard this when we talk to firms, you know, that the firm supports being collaborative, working on teams, organizing to meet the needs of a diverse set of clients. Well, all I can tell you is when you speak to attorneys at the firm, they will share countless examples that support the fact that Saul Ewing really does embrace this culture of collaboration. And really what it allows us to do is provide a wide array of services to a diverse set of clients. And I have absolutely found that to be true since joining the firm. The words that I heard in those initial interviews have absolutely been true.
I think the firm's strongest selling point is the integration plan. I really think that having this written integration plan where you're coming in, you know that there are people that have similar practices to you, you can go out, you can talk to them, you can talk about synergies, and you can really hit the ground running. And I think that's a really strong selling point for any lateral that's coming in, to know that that the firm is dedicated to making sure that you succeed. And not only do they develop this plan, because I think developing the plan is one piece of it, but the firm checks in with you periodically to make sure you're working that plan and make sure you're getting the most out of it.
Saul Ewing actually comes up with a plan, a document, and it's not one page, it's several pages. And it's got all kinds of information. It talks, people here, before you come in, put a lot of thought into the types, who else in the firm could you work with? Could you cross sell with? Could maybe you expand your client, your relationship with your existing clients and offer services that they can provide. And how can we integrate you into the firm? And the plan has benchmarks and has check-ins after 30 days and 60 days. And there are people who are responsible for making sure that, that it's being tracked. That's real. That's tangible. That's not just saying we care about integrating laterals. That's showing how it's going to be done.
The firm has a force majeure litigation team that we formed in April of 2020, and it was a direct result of the global pandemic that all of us were going through. The firm saw a need that we would be dealing with force majeure issues more so than in normal times. And they created this task force that's comprised of about 25 litigators from across our footprint, and they asked me to lead it. So it was a really nice opportunity for me, having only been at the firm for about 6 months, to be put into a leadership position like that.
The firm allowed me the privilege of serving as the office managing partner for the Minneapolis office, which has continued to thrive and grow, not only under my leadership, but under the partnership and collaboration of the attorneys in the office and our departmental leadership throughout the firm.
I've grown my personal brand by becoming one of the co-leaders of Saul Ewing's White Collar Group and by using that platform to really market the full service capabilities that the firm has, both inside and outside of my group. The firm has done excellent work in the white collar space of growing a group with a lot of former AUSAs that really can do whatever is needed in that industry. And I've leveraged that to reach out to some of my contacts and encourage them to bring in work, both in the areas where I practice and in areas where some of my colleagues practice.
The leadership opportunities that I've had at the firm have been really great. When I first started, I started in the labor and employment practice group. And within about 2 years, I was given the opportunity to be a vice chair of the group. Through that role, I've had great experience with mentoring associates and working with the chair, Gary Eidelman. And I'm very lucky that this year I've been given the opportunity to co-chair that group.
It's no secret to anybody at the firm or those outside of the firm that I have a very, very close relationship with our marketing department. And the reason I say that is because I have a tremendous amount of respect for what they do. And I think they have absolutely met me more than halfway in all of the efforts that we've been collaboratively involved with since my start at the firm. So, you know, from helping me land interviews to making sure that I'm speaking at the best conferences, to making sure that my year over year goals are being met with mainstream and trade press outlets alike, the amount of support that I've gotten from our marketing department has been nothing short of amazing. And the results speak for themselves. Regularly quoted in, as I said, mainstream and trade press outlets alike, bylined articles in publications that you would want to have your articles appear in, speaking at conferences nationally and internationally. It is not difficult to develop a practice and become a recognized thought leader when your name is at the top of whatever internet search provider you want to use as being a thought leader in a particular field. So I am forever indebted to our marketing department.
I've been practicing for 20 years, and I've got to tell you, the firm's marketing and PR department and IT departments are far above anything that I've ever experienced before. In most situations, I think, and speaking with some of my colleagues at other firms, those departments tend to be reactive as opposed to proactive. That is absolutely not the case at Saul Ewing, and I was delighted, quite frankly, overjoyed to see that not only are they not sitting there being reactive, but they're proactive to the point that I have a hard time keeping up with them.
They're constantly bringing me suggestions for things to do, always bringing me speaking engagements and opportunities. Within my first few months at the firm, they really helped me do a lot of different things. For instance, getting an article published and making sure the legal trade journals announced my arrival. And since then, it's just been constant contact with the marketing department. And they've really helped me hit the ground running in that way. The information technology or information services department has also been fantastic. I came over with quite a few patent and trademark prosecution files, and moving those files into the Saul Ewing system is a huge undertaking, and they really made it easy for me.
I feel like I'm part of a team. More so than that, I feel like I'm part of a family. What we do is hard. It's not easy. I love it. And it's beyond amazing to be able to be part of something where you feel like they get it, they get what you need, and they're willing to put their you know, entire weight behind helping you be successful, become more successful. Anything that you need, they are there for you at every level, by the way. Everyone is accessible. And for the first time in 20 years, I can honestly say that I truly love where I work.
The firm is bringing in lateral partners and not saying, okay, what can you do for us? The firm says, what can we do for you to help you grow and succeed? Because we know that it'll benefit everybody. And that really, in my experience, sets this firm apart. If you're looking for firms where you want to grow your practice, where you want to build your practice, where you want a platform of people who are going to help you do that, this is really a firm that you need to take a good look at.
For all laterals considering joining Saul Ewing Arnstein and Lehr, what I would ask you is, are you looking to take your practice to the next level? If you have an entrepreneurial spirit, if you're looking to roll up your sleeves, partner and collaborate not only internally with the business development and marketing team, with departmental leaders, but most importantly, with your colleagues, this may be the best platform for you to execute your vision for having a thriving practice.
How would I describe Saul Ewing in one word?
In one word?
One word.
In one word?
That word would be supportive.
Partnership.
Synergistic.
I would say entrepreneurial.
Progressive.
Collaborative.
How would I describe Saul Ewing in one word? Family.